So here's the ratings, everybody. Let me see if I can get it right this time.
Take a deep breath.
Okay. I don't want to take a deep breath.
Go slowly.
That's what I tell my 3-year-old.
Yeah, and it works for her, doesn't it?
No.
Oh.
You're clearly not over here now.
My bad. My mistake.
Yeah. Oh, man. When she's in it, when she goes 0 to 60, and then when I say, hey, take a deep breath, it goes to 120.
Your daughter.
Yeah.
That's
can
odd.
You believe that?
Strange where she get that habit.
So anyway, AEW Dynamite did 940,000 viewers last night.
It won.
Yes. And NXT, which is not AEW.
It is not.
It's NXT. They did 700,000 viewers.
They lost.
So the big change from last week was that they actually charted this week.
That's an improvement.
NXT went from 54th to whatever this week. 31st, I think. That's a big improvement. 0.21 in 18 to 49. AEW 0.38 in 18 to 49.
Okay.
So, I mean, the real big news is that forget AEW beating NXT. AEW beat the NBA game.
That is
on ESPN.
Actually. That's huge.
Yes. They beat the NBA. So, anyway, this was exactly where I figured that they would settle in, which was AEW doing around 900,000, and I thought that NXT would do a little better than 700,000. Maybe they'll creep up a little bit, but I mean, it's abundantly clear that that period where they were neck and neck was all about when they sent those main roster guys down to NXT.
Yes. That...
You put your Becky Lynch and your whoever on NXT, and they're going to do better. And it will take a bite out of AEW. But if you do regular run-of-the-mill, and I say that in the nicest way possible because I really like the NXT show. But if you just do NXT, it's not going to do as good as AEW. And the lesson that I learn here every week is that, yes, I want really good wrestling on Raw, and I want really good wrestling on SmackDown, and I hate stuff like The Wedding, but the reality is, I mean, pro wrestling fans want a pro wrestling show. And that means good matches and angles and storylines.
And fun promos.
And promos, like promo segments, and people that they perceive as big stars.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact of the matter is, like, the thing that everybody says is, if you try to make everybody a star, then nobody's going to be a star.
Yes.
And to a degree, that's true. If you like, if you push everybody equally, you will not have any stars. But AEW, they have people that are at a different level. Jericho, Moxley, Cody, guys like that. But everybody below that level, they are trying to get those people over. They're trying to make those people into stars. And when I watch NXT, it reminds me a lot of the main roster in the sense that there are certain people who are going to be over, and then the people in the middle are not going to get over, and they're not going to try to get them over. So I think that's the big difference here. The AEW crew, their fans see them all as the big AEW stars. And the NXT fans, they see the people on Raw and SmackDown as the big stars. And they do not see the NXT wrestlers at that level. And that's too bad. So that's the story of the ratings, everybody. AEW just signed a new deal. Everyone knows about that. They're going to get another hour. They're doing extraordinarily well. I don't think any promotion in the history of man went from 0 to 60, just like my daughter, in the span of 3 months like AEW has done.
That is light speed fast.
They're doing about 1 million viewers on TNT. They started from scratch. They just signed a brand new television deal. They're profitable.
That's amazing.
I mean, do you know how long it took WCW to become profitable?
Like a decade.
And they had Ted Turner backing them.
Yeah.
And then when they were profitable, they lasted 2 years, and then they were wildly unprofitable.
And then they died.
Now, granted, that could happen here, but
sure.
It's not going to.
It happened to them.